Morning, y'all. Welcome back to Zine Outdoors. Today is the morning of December 2nd. I'm headed out to my buddy's property in Hondo. It's about a four and a half hour drive. I'm actually stopping by my grandma's first and then gonna head out that way to say hi and bring her some lunch. It's raining pretty good right now, so hopefully that slows up. It looks like once I get out of Houston, it'll stop. But we're going out to his property and we're gonna hunt for about 4 or 5 days. His dad's gonna be out there and another friend or two are going also. They lost their running water a couple days ago, so hopefully we can try and get that fixed. Otherwise, we're gonna be roughing it a little bit out there. So we hunted this property last year and didn't really see a ton. A couple of the properties around them put up game fences, so they feel like they lost a couple deer to the game fences. But they've said that there's been a little bit more activity this year, so we didn't take anything off the property last year. They do have a handful of hogs out there as well. I brought my bow and my rifle. I'll be setting up probably in a ground blind somewhere, maybe try and scout a little bit, see if there's any good sign. I've got the pup along with me. He's probably a little confused. He's been to about 6 different places in 2 weeks, so I'm sure he's gonna be happy though to hang out with some of his dog friends. Either way, we'll get there about 2 or 3 o'clock and head out for an afternoon hunt, so I'll turn y'all on when I get there. We just got here. It's about 3:57, so I'm gonna go ahead and grab my 308. We've got a north wind, so I'm gonna walk the south fence line, just looking for sign. If I see something good, I'll stop and hang out. Otherwise, I'm just kind of looking for a good spot to set up for in the morning or tomorrow afternoon. But I have my 308 with the scope mount Tacticam, and I'll have a Tacticam that I put on my head as well. So hopefully if something shows up, I'll get it on video. See y'all guys out there. There's been a lot of coyote sign. You've got some deer prints here. But I've been walking this south fence line. I've seen a lot of coyote sign. So I think I found where they're bedding. I came along here and then up, and I've seen a lot of deer droppings. Here's some fresh ones. That looks like a old perennial rub right there. So I feel like I'm definitely in their bedroom a little bit here. Thank you.
Meh.
So we're sitting up here. It's about, what, 7 o'clock? 7:15. The feeder went off at 6:45. And immediately we had four doe show up. And within minutes, they just started trickling in. We ended up having, I think, 9 or 10 doe just sitting out on this feeder. Most of them looked pretty young. There's a bigger one in the back. But our buddy Travis is at a different blind, and we're waiting to see if he's going to get himself a buck first before we take a shot at anything. We're out here for, what, 4 days?
Yeah.
We're out here for 4 days, so we got some time, but definitely need to manage the doe population a little bit. So we'll probably try and take a doe or two out of this feeder. Trail goes right through there, right across there. I got my blind set up there, and there's some trails on that side as well. December 3rd. It's about 3:20. I'm set up in a pop-up blind. There's a lot of deer sign we've seen around here. There's some heavy deer trails going on my left, and I showed y'all walking in the down there. And right after that gunshot from Travis, I had a red fox come out just to the left of me of about 10 yards or so, and then saw me and got up into the woods. Alright, so he just texted me.
Alright guys, it is Friday the 4th. We are on our last hunt of the afternoon. Chris is trying to shoot a doe here. Two doe?
One doe.
One doe. He's trying to shoot one doe. We just got our rifles nice and sighted in, so we're good to go. We're heading out to the back blind where Travis shot his buck yesterday.
see you in the back. Looks like a spike. Yeah, it's a one spike. Those look like doe. Spike is far left. And then a doe. And a doe. And the buck is in the back behind. The buck is between the two does. And this doe up front's a pretty good size. Nope, she's gone away. Kind of small.